Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure as Chancellor to welcome you all here to this very important ceremony. So on behalf of the Senate and the Council, formally, it's my pleasure to open this degree ceremony. Now, will you please all sit down?
Distinguished guests, parents, families, friends and supporters, and most importantly, of course, graduates, good morning. We are here on a special day. We hope one of the most memorable of your lives, the culmination of years of education and the beginnings of new challenges, perhaps in education or new careers. You've worked and studied hard, and you have succeeded. You've done your job, and now, as President and Vice Chancellor, it's my job to welcome you to this degree congregation, where we formally recognise your achievement. You are graduating from one of the top-ranked universities in the country, in the top 1% worldwide, and you should be as proud of that as your assembled parents and loved ones are of you. As proud as those of us who've been charged with overseeing your research, marking your essays, or assessing your projects, and watching your thoughts evolve. As you go out into the world, you take your time at Leicester, everything that you've learned and experienced here, and of course, our very best wishes. Our very best wishes, and also some names, some letters after your name. A greater chance of the professional life that you seek. There are now more jobs for graduates than there have ever been. Over your working lifetime, you'll earn an estimated £200,000 more because of your hard work here. And, for once, the premium is even larger for women than for men. And you take new skills. You can write dissertations, solve complex problems, work in teams, take on particularly testing exam questions, solve simultaneous equations, and quote from philosophers. But it's even deeper than that. Our purpose is to equip you not just with an education, but with something broader, with the spirit of intellectual inquiry, with a deep curiosity, and with the resilience and the resources to go out into the world and go a long way. At last year's graduation ceremony, we were still celebrating our greatest local achievement, locating the body of England's last medieval king under a Leicester car park. A one in a million find, according to our expert who led the excavation, and who subsequently had to eat his hat, as you'll see if you visit the Richard III Visitor Centre. If you walk through the centre of campus today, you'll see that the main car park, between the Student Union and the library, is now being dug up. I've no idea why, but I did hear one of our archaeologists muttering something about Cardinal Wolsey. Of course, proving that it was the body of Richard III was only possible because of another famous Leicester discovery, DNA fingerprinting. And this demonstrates that we encompass the full range of academic disciplines here at the University of Leicester. Our research interests span all the way from DNA strands to the telescopes and space vehicles that explore the furthest stretches of the universe. As we speak, Leicester academics are working with international space agencies on what's been described as the hardest thing NASA has ever done, successfully sending a spaceship called Juno into orbit around Jupiter, 365 million miles away. Juno is solar powered, and in the course of her journey, she'll travel further from the sun than any solar-powered spacecraft in history. And for 20 months, she'll orbit Jupiter, allowing us to solve mysteries. How our solar system came into being, how Jupiter can be mapped, what we, in the end, are made of. Of course, it's this spirit of discovery that we hope we've instilled in you as a graduate. Discovery is about imaginative new thinking, underpinning fundamental advances in our understanding of the world around us, and applying that expertise to business and community needs, and delivering solutions to global challenges. And there will be challenges ahead. I think it's worth reflecting briefly on the momentous decision our nation took just last month to leave the EU. There will, of course, be different views about this, and the implications are difficult to judge. But the universities across the UK were unanimous in their view that we should remain. We value the free movement of scientists because world-class science benefits from bringing the very best minds together. It's perhaps not a surprise that 90% of academics and 70% of students voted to remain. Perhaps most concerning, though, is the fact that the academic and other so-called expert voices were not able to make the argument compelling enough. And we should reflect on what that means for our ability to engage productively with issues of great public concern. This challenge is one that the university takes up. Over the next years, we'll work to make the case for the cooperative scientific values that we hold dear. And there's a lesson for us, as well as for you. Very little that's worthwhile is easy. Everyone can succeed if they're determined enough. And sometimes that can be against all the odds. So you won't be surprised to hear me mention perhaps the most unexpected sporting achievement there's ever been, which happened in Leicester this year. One that attracted worldwide attention and no doubt will be the next Disney feel-good movie. It's, of course, the outstanding victory for the University of Leicester in the annual varsity match against EMU. Capped off with the women's rugby team's 13th win in as many years, and a spectacular performance by the women's sports president, who scored 5 tries and converted 4 of them. Oh, and of course, the city's football team also had a fairly good run this year. It was wonderful to see the whole city, 250,000 people, out in the park behind us celebrating that achievement. One that at the beginning of the season had longer odds than either Elvis or the Loch Ness Monster being found. In fact, the odds were shorter on Simon Cowell becoming Prime Minister or on Andy Murray naming his firstborn Novak. So there will inevitably be ups and downs in the years ahead. If we've done our jobs right, if we've equipped you with the resources and with the values of our university, if your time here has been everything that I hope it's been, you will find your way through. And we fully expect to be as proud of you in the future as we are today. Do stay in touch. Tell us what happens next. If we can help, let us know. And carry the pride of Leicester with you. As our physicists might say, proudly go where no graduates of Leicester have gone before. I congratulate you on the degrees that you've obtained and wish you an enjoyable day and a happy future. On behalf of all of the University of Leicester, I wish you every success.
Our honorary graduate, Tony Allcock, is no stranger to this stage. When he was 10 years old, Tony won the W.D. Cartel Memorial Trophy for Boy Treble in the De Montfort Hall. He went on to win singing competitions in Tamworth, Derby and Leicester, where he sang all the classics for boy soprano. Clearly, before the age of 12, Tony had learned how to compete and how to be the best at anything that he did. Few players of bowls can say that they were born into the sport, but with Tony's parents, both of Tony's parents were county bowlers, and his mother became an England international. Tony was born in Thurmaston, Leicester. His mother was involved in bowling competitions before and after the happy event. Indeed, Tony was taken to the 1955 Goodwood Ladies Bowling Club Championships before his first birthday. Tony came from a close family, and although he was not pushed into taking up bowls, he was to be seen when very young playing his own version of bowls on rough ground near bowling competitions where his parents were taking part. He quickly absorbed a sound understanding of tactics, which enabled him to apply his considerable technical skills, and he enjoyed significant success as a junior. During his teenage years, Tony practiced like a demon. He loved the game for its intrinsic beauty and for the outlet it provided for his competitive nature. Tony started at Fosway Bowling Club in Syston. He then moved on to Goodwood Bowling Club in Leicester, where his parents played. Tony soon began to compete for his county, and his clear ambition was to wear the English rose on his blazer as a representative of England. Tony's first job was as a teacher in Millfield Day Centre in Hinckley, which was a school for adults with learning difficulties. Later, at the age of 24, he was appointed a head teacher at another school in Gloucestershire, which necessitated a move to Cheltenham. Concern for the disabled has stayed with Tony throughout his career. Tony won his first bowls competition in 1972 at the age of 17. He went on to become English junior singles champion three times. It was as a 30-year-old in 1986 that he won the first of his 15 world titles, much to the chagrin of many in the bowling community who regarded the pipe-smoking David Bryant as their favourite. Who was this slim-hipped young whippersnapper with the David Gower curls and the tight white flannels? Tony and David Bryant were fierce rivals, but also close friends. In fact, Tony and David won the World Indoor Pairs Championship six times. Tony was voted Player of the Year three times by the readers of Bowls International, and he was awarded an MBE in 1989 at the age of 34 for his services to sport and the community. In his home village of Thurmaston, a full-life bronze statue of Tony was erected. Tony is a fellow of the University of Gloucestershire, his second county, and he has been awarded the Freedom of Cheltenham. When in 2003, Tony won both the mixed and the men's pairs titles at the World Indoor Championships, the crowd gave him two standing ovations, and to the strains of Tina Turner singing Simply the Best, Tony's brilliant career came to an end. He then moved into coaching. Always concerned to help the disabled, one of his proudest moments was when he trained 69-year-old Ruth Small to win the Commonwealth Games gold medal for visually handicapped bowlers in Manchester. Ruth was totally blind. When played with passion, bowls can keep older minds active and in some cases keep the elderly out of nursing homes. Tony then served on the governing body of the sport, becoming chief executive of the English Bowling Association and Bowls England, an organisation which serves 110,000 members. Tony has written or been co-author on five books on bowls and produced a four-volume video set called Tony Allcock's Art of Bowls. Since leaving bowls, Tony has followed another passion, dog showing, breeding, and judging. And as we have established, Tony needs to be the best at whatever he does. He has bred and shown 23 English champions, and he has been a judge at international dog shows. In 2015, he was elected director of the Kennel Club, and this year he was a judge at Crufts. Tony Allcock has demonstrated that bowls is not just an old man's sport. David Gourlay, world number one bowler, declared, "Tony Allcock is the greatest all-round bowler in the history of the sport." Mr. Chancellor, on the authority of the Senate and the Council, I present Anthony Allcock so that you may confer on him the degree of Doctor of Laws.
Well done, sir. Well done indeed. What a achievement. There we are. I've watched you many times. Yes, I have indeed.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and graduates, of course. It is a great honour to be standing once again on this stage in the town and the city in which I love and was born. Yes, I have followed a distinguished career, not only in education, but in sport. And as we stand on the threshold of life, and I see all of you here sitting today thinking about the next move in life, I had those decisions to make. And from my own perspective, I've always followed my own heart, even to the point that I retired from my sport as a world champion some 14 years ago and have never played since. I realized that that was not the right thing for me to do. I'm sure you're sitting there thinking about your next step in life. We make the plans, and as far as I'm concerned, my life has been diverse. There has been many shortcuts and many different avenues taken. But I followed my heart in the knowledge that if I look forward, I go forward. If I look behind me, I will fall down. I represent a sport which perhaps is predominantly those people who have retired from other sports. Notwithstanding the fact that the British Isles are the finest players in the world and our Commonwealth Games gold medalists from England and Scotland are all in their 20s. One thing's for sure, people sitting there, you're on the threshold of careers, but you're also going to be old like me. And it was delighted that the Chancellor said that he'd watched me many times, and obviously he had on television playing bowls, and obviously he too had a black and white TV. It was many years ago. It's great to be back in the city of Leicester in a year of which we've already heard was a great sporting occasion for Leicester. Last year, Richard III, this year, the Premier League. How diverse is that? Such is this wonderful city of which all of you will have enjoyed over the last few years. It's much easier to play the final bowl in a World Championship or in a Commonwealth Games, but not so easy to be confronted with such an academic audience. And as I stand here, I was very nervous initially to be making this address amongst this august assembly. But one thing is for sure, it's your day. It's a very special day. A memorable day for you and all of those family members and friends that have supported you so far. You need them. I'm greatly indebted to my friends and families for the support that they gave me in my life. I certainly wouldn't be receiving this honor today without their help. Please acknowledge and remember them. And after the ceremony, please go and enjoy the wilds of Leicester. Enjoy your day. You have thoroughly enjoyed it. Thank you very much indeed.
Will all graduands please stand?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Senate, I formally admit candidates, both present and absent, for the several degrees for which you are presented. And now, please, if you'll sit down and you'll be asked to come up on the stage in groups. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Mr. Chancellor, on behalf of the Head of the College of Social Sciences, Arts and Humanities, I present the following candidates for their degrees. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Adeolu Adesanya.
Congratulations. Doctor, that's pretty good, that is. Yeah, well, that's good stuff.
Nicola Barden.
Thank you, being a doctor. I've never managed that, then.
Hayley Harris.
Well done, Hayley. Doctor, that is pretty good, that is.
Freddy Mora Gomez.
Congratulations to you. Well done, indeed. Big achievement.
Thomas Swan.
Well done, Thomas. Congratulations to you.
For the degree of Doctor of Social Sciences, Irina Loktina.
Congratulations, Doctor.
For the degree of Master of Arts in Psychodynamic Counselling and Psychotherapy, Wendy Padley.
Well done, Wendy.
Rachel Shorthose.
Well done, Rachel.
Tracy Thomas.
Well done, Tracy. Congratulations to you.
Faye Tao. Sophia Turner.
Well done, Sophia.
Michelle Wynn.
Well done, Michelle. Good stuff.
For the degree of Master of Business Administration, Rodolin Akar.
Congratulations, well done.
Nekeisha Adams. Emmanuel Kwashie Ogbodzi. Kylie Agius. Olwatoyin Aina. Olesogun Ajibade. Lorotime Alade. Rafat Alburi. Motlak Alharbi. Ghanim Ashalwani. Majed Al Soleimani. Saud Al Utaibi.
Congratulations.
Tushan Amarasuria. Michael Ni Amu Amu.
Thank you, indeed.
Henry Anan. Carmel Anzenge. Georgios Argirakis. Rafi Baboyan. Colin Beige. Bassam Barakat. Ahmad Bdour. Kwame Brifo. Amanda Brown.
Well done, Amanda.
Howard Carr.
Well done, Howard. Congratulations.
Moesia Conte.
Congratulations.
Mahesh Dalmadasa.
Well done, Amanda.
Patience Zikunu.
Well done, too. Well done.
Dennis Edugon. David Egbunu.
Well done,
Ibrahim El Kouri.
Well done, Ibrahim. Well done, Ibrahim.
Taha El Adawi. Amir El Refai. Nadun El Vitigala. Pavlos Evangelatos. Mohamed Fatih Kola. Oluwabunmi Gaji. Bernard Guarada. Wissam Hachem. Mohamed Hamid. Shirley Hannon. Catherine Healy.
Congratulations to you, Catherine. Well done.
Eric Hope.
Well done.
Mohamed Ibrahim.
Well done, Mohamed. Congratulations to you.
Jennifer Iwuchukwu. Possibly not. Chaya Devi Jagusar.
Congratulations to you. Well done indeed.
Mohamed Jalo.
Well done, Mohamed. Congratulations.
Prasanga Katuri Arakchi.
Congratulations.
Rita Kene Nwekwe.
Congratulations to you. Well done.
Mark Kenny.
Well done, Mark.
Ayub Khan Khan.
Congratulations to you.
Mohamed Khadiri. Claire Cook.
Well done, Claire.
Daniel Kwawu.
Well done, Daniel.
Pamela Liswaniso.
Nice welcome. Well done.
Natalia McIver.
Well done, Natalia. Well done.
Nkiru Kamaka.
Congratulations to you. Well done, indeed. Well done.
Mercy Moma.
Congratulations to you. Well done.
Maher Musa.
Well done, indeed.
Luindo Munkombwe. Latifa Mustafa. Evelyn Wikali.
Well done, indeed.
Catherine Mishka.
Well done, Catherine. Good.
Fadine Nassif. Michael Nelson.
Hello, Michael. Good.
Luke Newman.
Well done, Luke.
Wange Nagamate.
Well done, indeed.
Esther Ngomele.
Congratulations.
Karim Neem.
Well done, indeed.
Ryan Nurse. Brenda Nayemba.
Congratulations.
Anthony Obaji.
Well done, Anthony.
Rogers Obare. Cheryl Sooms Odiambo.
Well done, Anthony. Congratulations.
Winston Odiambo.
Well done, Winston.
Oluwatoyin Oke.
Well done, Winston.
Elizabeth Orika.
Well done, Winston.
Oluwatosin Otoikoya.
Congratulations.
Fando Otu. Margaret Adzoa Ota Atikpo.
Well done, Margaret. Well done, indeed.
Perichepan Palaniapan.
Congratulations.
Gonduagwe Pereira. Farah Kadri.
Congratulations to you. Well done indeed.
Swarup Ramadugu.
Congratulations to you.
Ari Robi.
Congratulations to you.
Jeffrey Bruno.
Well done, Jeffrey.
Mohamed Sabra.
Well done indeed. Congratulations.
Bobby Sakaria.
Congratulations to you.
Jayesh Kumar Samani.
Congratulations.
Ruba Samua.
Very nice welcome. Congratulations.
Mohammed Shaheen.
Well done, Mohammed.
Samer Sharafedin. Paul Sutters.
Congratulations.
Candice Adoyabi Sionwuka. Nilesh Udas.
There we are, I can see them.
Erica Asher.
Well done, indeed.
Osameke Uwagbai. Kelechi Uzoma.
Well done, indeed.
Mohana Priya Venkatalacham. Sekan Second Wong. Maria Yaluru.
Well done, Maria. Well done, indeed.
For the degree of Master of Science in Criminology, Daniel Bolger.
Well done, Daniel.
Kairu Azri Ismail.
Congratulations.
Pooja Kanda.
Congratulations. Well done, indeed.
For the degree of Master of Science in Criminology and Criminal Justice, Christopher Bonn.
Well done, Christopher. Congratulations.
Shamira Mandu.
Well done, Shamira.
Stamatina Trokani.
Congratulations.
For the degree of Master of Science in Finance, Richard Belcher.
Well done, Richard. Congratulations.
Adrian Bonanno.
Well done, Adrian. Congratulations.
Mao Mao Chen.
Well done, Adrian. Congratulations.
Christiana Ibe.
Well done, Christian. Well done.
Polakale Ibrahim.
Congratulations, Jim.
Hannah Kerrigan.
Well done. Congratulations, Jim.
Helder Sandro Menezes de Guedia.
Well done, Jim.
Bancole Odusanya.
Congratulations, Jim.
Bronke Olaleye.
Congratulations to you.
Kehinde Olamajobi.
Congratulations.
Babatunji Olotu.
Well done, indeed.
Aniska Roll.
Congratulations.
Stephanie Staringer.
Well done, Stephanie.
Wenhao Sun.
Well done to you.
Is Elizabeth Tomoloju Okonomo.
Well done, indeed. Congratulations.
Wei Huang.
Congratulations, too.
For the degree of Master of Science in Human Resource Management and Training, Ali Al Amri.
Well done, indeed. Good.
Islam El Kuli. Engelbert Galea.
Well done, congratulations.
Jinying Li.
Well done, Jinying. Well done, Jinying.
Hayley Murphy.
Well done, Hayley.
Venus Mutimusakwa Showa. Bertha Alfori. Asiya Patel. Mark Rogers. Olwakemi Modupe Seidi. Bhavni Sharma. Ibiduni Toyin Udumbaku. Onyum Ogbagbe. Aohang Zhu. With a degree of Master of Science in Management, Pinar Kaglar. Nitisha Joshi. Oksana Kulika. Teresa Smith.
Well done, Teresa.
Francis Vickerstaff.
Well done, Francis.
With a degree of Master of Science in Management, Finance and Accounting, Jie Kiao. For the degree of Master of Science in Marketing, Joanna Bray. Shi Chen. Si Yuan Chong. Andrew Hogarth. Adele Howes.
Well done, Adele.
Chengfei Zhang. Chuanzhu Li. Rochelle Miller.
Well done, congratulations.
Daniel Merton.
Well done, Daniel.
Tanaka Mushayavanu. Olufalokemi Ogini. Yeah, yeah, Paul.
Well done, congratulations.
Mark Tidbury.
Well done,
for the degree of Master of Science in Performance Management and Workplace Learning, Peter Boyle.
Well done, Peter.
Paul Horn. For the degree of Master of Science in Risk, Crisis and Disaster Management, Charles Bassey. Nadia A. El-Batal. Rebecca Gurney. Stephen Marshall. Andrew Murr. Christopher Wildsmith. For the degree of Master of Science in Security, Conflict and International Development, Prince Chanai. Kofi Dwodu. Alan Jones. Robert Reynolds. Richard Savage. Anthony John Thomas. Mariana Tonuti. For the degree of Master of Science in Security and Risk Management, Romeo Bekeye. Francisco Camano Gutierrez. Emerantia Klassen. Brian Gill. Henri Norst. Lukman Afolabi Longe. Darren Maxted. Terry O'Connor. Ian Richmond. Matthew Sinden. Stuart Smith. Richard Swain. For the degree of Master of Science in Terrorism, Security and Policing, Zulfikar Sher. For the Postgraduate Certificate in Management, Wendy Young. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Criminology, Antonia Adams. Pavel Bartniki. Gemma Bingham. Well done, Alice Bulger. Well done, Lauren Brain. Well done, Lauren Brown. Well done, Elliot Button. Well done, Catherine Camano Chavez. Amy Carmichael. Well done, Amy. Jatinda Chima. Mohsin Chowdhury. Grace Clark. Well done, Grace. Well done. Chloe Crew. Monica Danielska. Joshua Dodsley. Joshua Ellard. Joshua Fountain. Rachel Freeman. Daphne Frones. Hannah Godbold. Well done, Hannah. Shannon Grosvenor. Well done. Zoe Hamilton.
Well done, Hannah. Congratulations.
Hayley Hansen.
What a nice welcome that was.
Amy Hayes.
Well done, Amy.
Rebecca Heens. Benjamin Isherwood.
Well done, Benjamin.
Sarah Gina. Hannah Johnson.
Well done,
Bamidele Jolu Asu. Sarah Jolly. Lida Ketsbaya. Justine Knopp. Hazel Knorr.
Well done, Hazel.
Alexander Lewis.
Well done, Alexander.
Samantha Lewis.
Well done, Samantha.
Tanya Lightfoot Taylor.
Well done, Tanya. Well done.
Laura Lowe.
Well done, Laura.
Dwayne Lynch. Trishna Mal. Arden Mayer. Niyasha Mwanewangapul. Scott Nash. Ka Ng. Elizabeth Orotayo. Melissa Page. Saguna Pankania. Shamas Pervez. Laura Presura. Chloe Rawson. Connor Robinson.
Well done, Connor. Good stuff here.
Chantel Rose. Cameron Ross.
Well done, Cameron. Well done.
Sarah Rowling. Benjamin Russell.
Well done, Benjamin. Well done.
Louisa Schmidt. Sarah Spencer.
Well done, Sarah. Well done.
Mill Tang. Louise Taylor. Simon Thompson.
Well done, Simon.
Mitchell Topham.
Congratulations, well done.
Max Walker.
Max. Well done. Good stuff.
Hannah Watson.
Well done, Max. Good stuff.
Rebecca Watts.
Well done, Rebecca.
Rebecca Weeks. Rhea White.
Well done, Rhea.
Ellis Wilsden.
Congratulations.
Matthew Wing.
Well done,
Bankers, according to recent surveys, are one of the professions least trusted by the public, kept off the bottom of that list of shame only by politicians and journalists. Today, we celebrate the achievements of one of the few leaders of the British financial services industry to emerge with credit from the crisis which began in 2008. Graham Beale assumed the position of Chief Executive of the Nationwide Building Society in 2007, just in time to deal with the worst crisis in the sector in living memory, and possibly even since the bursting of the South Sea bubble in the early 18th century. In the 9 years in which he ran the society, while banks and building societies famous internationally for their apparent dependability collapsed or suffered radical restructuring, the Nationwide thrived and grew, strengthening its reputation for integrity. And Graham became recognized, as the Sunday Times put it, as a chief executive who leads by example, running a company based on sound moral principles. A career at the top of a business with assets of over £200 billion, 17,500 employees, and 15 million members and customers was far from Graham Beale's aspirations as a child. He joined this university as a student in 1977, armed with excellent reports from school, where he'd been deputy head boy, and with enthusiasms for motorcycling and modern jazz, as well as for his subject, psychology. But inasmuch as he had considered the future, it was a career in marketing that beckoned. The nearest he came to fulfilling that ambition was immediately after his graduation, when he took a temporary job as a sales assistant on the Leicester Mercury. While a student, and like many students before and since, including our Chancellor, Graham had one particularly important life-changing experience. He met his future wife, Roz, in his first week here. They married straight after graduation, Roz securing a good job at the City Council. And Graham recognised that he had a responsibility to support his new family and establish a career of his own. So, as he puts it, as a sensible step, rather than from a burning ambition, he started as an articled clerk with Thompson McClintock, training to be a chartered accountant and developing the skills which have underpinned his subsequent successes in business and informed his response to its challenges. The next critical step was our Honour Anne's decision in 1985 to take a job at the Anglia Building Society, prompted partly by having done work for Thompson McClintock at the Leicester Building Society. 2 years later, the Anglia merged with the Nationwide, a movement which made it already one of the largest mutuals, businesses which are run for the benefit of those who bank with them or borrow from them. The Nationwide's determination to retain this status and its success in doing so against the trend in the last quarter of the 20th century has set it apart and has formed the basis for its current strength. Graham, who rose to become Divisional Director for Commercial Lending and then Group Finance Director, is a passionate believer in this business model. He very properly acknowledges the influence that his predecessors, Brian Davis and Philip Williamson, have had on him in developing this philosophy. But we recognise his unique contribution both to the Nationwide and to the wider sector in steering them through the storms of 2008 and after, with their members' resources protected and that philosophy intact. Those who know Graham best testify to the passion he brings to everything he sets his hand to. He believes, quite simply, in helping people make the most of their financial affairs. We have seen with our own eyes ample evidence that this has not been the approach of many banks, which have been motivated to make a profit at almost any cost, and which have suffered as a consequence. Under Graham's leadership, and thanks to his well-earned reputation for integrity, the Nationwide stability was never in doubt, and he was able to use this strength to rescue other societies. He was also determined to ensure that the business kept pace with technological change, and his professional standing was recognised when he was elected chairman of the Building Society's Association. His success is further reflected in his recognition by the Times as one of the 7 business people of the year in 2015, when he was described as one of the best, if not the best, chief executives in Britain. Earlier this year, the Sunday Times listed the Nationwide as the 3rd best company to work for in the UK, acknowledging its strong social conscience and ranking it top for giving something back. The Queen has appointed Graham Commander of the Order of the British Empire, an honour which in itself symbolises the slow recovery of the reputation of British banking to which Graham has contributed so much. Fittingly, for the head of an organisation which helps so many home buyers, the Nationwide provided nearly half the residential lending in the worst years of the crisis, Graham has had a lifelong enthusiasm for architecture and the restoration of houses. But it is for his restoration of decency and our faith in the financial services sector more than anything else that we are particularly proud of this distinguished and honourable alumnus. Mr. Chancellor, on the recommendation of the Senate and the Council, I present Graham John Beale, that you may confer on him the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws.
And a left together as well, and you are here, as I do. Yes, there we are. There we are. Terrific.
think it's good afternoon, Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, graduates, graduands, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. And thank you, Nigel, for that introduction and kind words. For me, it's a great honour to be here today, and I'm very grateful to the University for the recognition that it has bestowed upon me. So 36 years ago, probably almost to the day I would imagine, I attended my own graduation ceremony in this very hall. And it would have been impossible for me then to predict my career and my life thereafter. But one thing is really clear, and that is that my time at this university and my adult years living in Leicester was a formative period in my life, and much of my subsequent success stems from my Leicester days. My time at Leicester University provided me with more than the degree in psychology. As Nigel has said, I met my wife here. She's sitting up there in the balcony, in the first week of the first term. She was reading law, and we were both staying in the same hall of residence, College Hall, which I think is now called College Court. We both graduated in July 1980, and we got married at Leicester Registry Office in the same year. We settled in Leicester, and we bought our first house in the city, believe it or not, for some less than £20,000. My intention and the degree choice was to have a career in marketing, but this never happened. And albeit a Hobson's choice, I trained to become a chartered accountant at Thomson McClintock, which is now part of KPMG. And actually, my office was just a short walk from here at the top of Newark. Becoming an accountant was one of the best decisions that I ever made, even if it was by default. But it was clear to me as I went through my articles that I did not want to stay in the profession. One of the audit clients was the Leicester Building Society, and on the back of that experience, I secured a role at Anglia Building Society, which is based in Northampton, in 1985. And then 2 years later, Anglia merged with Nationwide. So started my career with Nationwide, which has spanned 30 years. In the early years, I played to my strengths as an accountant, working in audit and finance functions. But my career developed into a corporate finance role, buying and selling assets and subsidiaries, and helping to reshape the Nationwide group and the business model. This included 4 years as a managing director of a corporate buy-to-let subsidiary up in Glasgow. And it was there that I acquired a taste for running a business, and at that point my career changed tack from being an accountant to becoming a business leader, although the accountant in me always remained strong. I returned to mainstream Nationwide in 2001. 15 months later, I joined the board as the group finance director. And 4 years after that, on the 1st of April 2007, at the age of 48, I became the chief executive of Nationwide. Let me tell you briefly about Nationwide. It's the UK's largest mutual organisation. It's the second largest provider of mortgage and savings products. And importantly, it's a building society, not a bank. It is mutual because it's owned by its customers. The society works entirely on their behalf and generates profits to invest for the future and to sustain growth, but not to profit shareholders. If you think crowdfunding is a modern invention, I would ask you to think again. In essence, Nationwide is a crowdfunder and has been since its inception in 1846. It takes in deposits from savers and it uses those funds to provide mortgage finance for home ownership. My mandate as chief executive in 2007 was to modernise the society whilst remaining true to its heritage and mutual status. It was clear that without modernisation, the society was unlikely to remain successful. I led the biggest ever transformation programme and investment programme, embracing our systems, the infrastructure, our processes, the culture, the leadership team, and including our proposition to our customers. It was a programme that was costing in excess of £1 billion. It involved a strategic merger with the Portman Building Society, which was the biggest transaction of its kind, and was anticipated to take several years to complete. And then Thursday, the 13th of 2007 happened. It's an important date because it's my wedding anniversary. But it's also the date that Robert Peston announced late that evening on the BBC that the Northern Rock Bank was about to fail. And so started the biggest, deepest financial crisis that the UK has ever experienced. The first 6 months were characterized by denial, nobody sure, nobody accepting the enormity of what was going wrong. By the end of 2008, the unthinkable had happened, and household name institutions such as Lehman's, Royal Bank of Scotland, Halifax Bank of Scotland had failed, along with a myriad of smaller institutions, including the old Leicester Building Society, which by then was the Alliance and Leicester Bank. I found myself thrust into a series of roundtable crisis talks at Number 10 and at Whitehall, sitting alongside the bank chief executives such as Fred Goodwin from the Royal Bank of Scotland and Andy Hornby from Halifax Bank of Scotland, and engaging with the Prime Minister, the Chancellor and other senior politicians and civil servants to work our way through the crisis. And I have to say, of all of the people that I worked with during that period, the then Chancellor, Alistair Darling, is one of my heroes because of the way that he dealt with those unprecedented events. The mutual sector was not immune. Only one building society failed, the Dunfermline, but many had to be rescued by merging with stronger societies. Nationwide rescued the Cheshire and the Derbyshire in this fashion, and we also acquired the retail customers from the Dunfermline. And all of that happened in the space of 3 months. My focus shifted radically from the transformation to intensive management of the balance sheet and the liquidity, as well as providing support and leadership for the rest of the mutual sector. Nationwide survived the crisis with its honour intact, and I'm very proud of the role that we played to stabilise the mutual sector and also our impact on the real economy, because we continued to lend when the banks had retrenched. In the worst 4 years of the recession, the mutual sector accounted for 83% of all of the net mortgage lending in the UK, and Nationwide alone accounted for almost half of all net lending, facilitating home ownership, especially for first-time buyers, and providing a safe haven for savers. Today, Nationwide is thriving. We have 15 million customers, and that's a relationship with one in four households in the United Kingdom. We employ 17,500 people. We operate through 700 branches, the internet, the mobile app, and the telephone. Last year was a record year for the society. It lent the most it ever lent in a single year, which is 32.6 billion, taking total assets to 209 billion, and it made a profit of 1.3 billion, which will be used to support future growth and investment in the society. And to put 32.6 billion of lending into context, that's equivalent to about £18 million for every hour that we operated last year. So having become the chief executive on April Fool's Day in 2007, I retired on April Fool's Day this year. I do like symmetry. For those of you graduating from Leicester today, I congratulate you. I wish you well and every success as you commence your own careers. I would encourage you to have a career plan, but to take opportunity when it presents itself. Work hard, be decisive. Take calculated risk, but not foolhardy risk. And most importantly, and linking back to my studies in psychology, develop and nurture your emotional intelligence, your EQ, because being able to create strong teams and winning the hearts and minds of those that are around you, they are critical success factors to becoming an effective leader in whichever field you choose. So thank you once again to Leicester University for inviting an old boy back. It's a very proud moment for me, and I am truly grateful. Thank you very much.
The University of Leicester chorus will now sing Va Pensiero in Italian in tribute to Signor Claudio Ranieri and the Leicester City football team. Details are on page 12 of your programme.
Oh,
Mr. President and Vice Chancellor, for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Humanities and Arts, Nicola Bailey.
Well done, Nicola.
Ross Baker.
Congratulations. Well done.
Surinda Bhatia.
Well done, Surinda. Congratulations.
Paul Bonick.
Well done, Paul.
Vicky Bolter.
Well done. Congratulations. Well done.
Glenise Bowyer.
Congratulations. Well done.
Agnes Joanne Chan.
Congratulations. Well done.
Sophie Chessman Smith.
Congratulations, Sophie. Well done.
Talvinda Flora.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Daniel Goldfinch.
Well done, Daniel.
Jane Goff.
Well done, Jane. Congratulations. Well done.
Elizabeth Gray.
Well done, Elizabeth. Congratulations.
Robert Greenhill.
Well done, Robert. Congratulations.
Jennifer Hollis.
Well done, Jennifer. Congratulations.
Richard Humphreys.
Well done, Richard. Congratulations.
Amanda Maynard.
Well done, Amanda. Congratulations.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies, Gloria Alabi.
Well done, Gloria. Well done.
Farhan Ali.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Adrian Aungon.
Congratulations. Well done.
Sara Bachu.
Congratulations. Well done.
Moritz Barsch.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Benjamin Catterall.
Well done, Benjamin, well done.
Sarah Chapman.
Well done, Sarah, congratulations.
Ho Chung.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Aldo Corral Viveros.
Splendid, well done.
Serban Dabelea.
Congratulations, well done.
Alexander Dean.
Well done, Alexander. Well done.
Hugh Din.
Congratulations. Well done.
John Duggan.
Well done, John. Congratulations.
Samuel Evans.
Well done, Samuel. Congratulations. Well done.
Agnieszka Florek.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Raghav Garg.
Well done. Congratulations.
Amarinda Gill.
Well done, Amarinda, well done.
Luke Govier.
Well done, Luke. Congratulations.
Andrew Graham.
Well done, Andrew. Congratulations.
Curtis Green.
Well done, Curtis. Congratulations.
Josephine Grostavnica.
Well done, Josephine. Well done.
Laura Hall Williams.
Wow, what a cheer. Well done.
Daniel Henry.
Well done, Daniel. Congratulations.
Ting Ting Huang.
Congratulations. Well done.
Yi Hong Hong.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Vestina Dorsaite.
Congratulations. Well done.
Lai Kam Phi.
Well done. Congratulations.
Yuan Jie Lao.
Good cheer there. Well done.
Jiameng Li.
Congratulations. Well done.
Na Li.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Junjie Yang.
Well done. Congratulations. Well done.
Weiping Yang.
Congratulations. Well done.
Jiameng Yang.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Shreya Lodia.
Well done. Congratulations.
Jade Mamluk.
Well done, Jade. Congratulations.
Sanjana Masalemani.
Congratulations. Well done.
Jamel Murray.
Well done, Jamel. Congratulations.
Tse Ning.
Congratulations. Well done.
D. Davina Parmar.
Well done, Davina. Congratulations.
Joseph Pope.
Well done, Joseph. Well done.
Gabiya Rakauskaite.
Congratulations. Well done.
Jie Rong.
Congratulations. Well done.
Samnit.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Ashil Shavdia.
Well done, Ashil. Congratulations.
Lei Shen.
Well done. Congratulations.
Adam Tipple.
Well done, Adam. Congratulations.
Chi Tong.
Congratulations. Well done.
Wan Sui.
Well done. Congratulations.
Alexander Tsarnov.
Congratulations. Well done, Alexander.
Viet Vu.
Congratulations. Well done.
Danica Vyas.
Congratulations. Well done.
Jin Wang.
Well done. Congratulations.
Wing Wong.
Congratulations. Well done.
Lily Zhu.
Congratulations. Well done.
Lei Zhui.
Splendid. Well done. Well done.
Garui Yang.
Congratulations. Well done.
Yunxie Yang.
Splendid. Congratulations. Well done.
Amsa Zana Ibrahim.
A great cheer. Well done.
Jin Zhang.
Well done. Congratulations.
Mengdi Zhang.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Yufai Zhang.
Well done. Congratulations.
Ji Zhang.
Splendid. Well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies, Finance, Faith Adegoke.
Well done, Faith. Congratulations.
Faisal Ahmed.
Well done. Congratulations.
Senab Ahmed Ibrahim.
Congratulations. Well done.
Ayobami Akinmolwa.
Congratulations. Well done.
Hardeep Bewas.
A good cheer, well done.
Zhaowen Chen.
Well done, congratulations.
Tianshu Chu.
Congratulations, well done.
Christopher Clatworthy.
Well done, Christopher. Well done.
Hong Dang.
Well done, congratulations.
Travis Francois Ivy.
Well done, congratulations.
Sanpreet Gill.
Well done, well done.
Zhen Yang Gu.
Well done, congratulations.
Wenfeng Huang.
Congratulations, well done.
Ji Yang Huo.
Congratulations, well done.
Ahmed Jama.
Well done, congratulations.
Ndaye Koji.
Congratulations, well done.
Qi Yong.
Splendid, congratulations, well done.
Yingzhi Lung, Li.
Congratulations, well done.
Erfan Mazlumi.
Well done, congratulations.
Liam McIntyre.
Well done, congratulations.
Nitin Mittal.
Well done, congratulations.
Hugh Mon.
Well done, congratulations.
Natasha Nkocha.
Well done, Natasha, what a cheer.
Iyanchi Chukwe Nwausu.
Congratulations, well done.
Adesola Odungba.
Congratulations, well done.
Philippe Palma Gill.
Well done, congratulations, well done.
Dharam Parekh.
Splendid, well done, congratulations.
Yankur Shen.
Congratulations, well done.
Nicholas Swalwell.
Well done. Congratulations.
Aidan Thompson.
Well done. Congratulations. Well done.
Di Tran.
Well done. Congratulations.
Hinai Vitlani.
Congratulations. Well done.
Kangan Zhui.
Well done. Congratulations.
Yurong Ye.
Well done, congratulations.
Koen Yim.
Congratulations, well done.
Saeed Zaman.
Congratulations, well done.
Cheng Zhang.
Well done, congratulations.
Zhou Ying Zhang.
Congratulations, well done.
Chen Jiao Zhu.
Well done, congratulations.
Dinglun Zhu.
Congratulations, well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies Marketing, Sunil Ashtar.
Well done, Sunil, congratulations.
Swafa Bayusuf.
Congratulations, well done.
Tat Chan.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Motefe Edeguare.
Congratulations, well done.
Timothy Edun Olusesi.
Well done, Timothy.
Lewis Evans.
Well done, Lewis. Congratulations.
Yue Fang.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Molly Gordon.
Congratulations. Well done.
Mehmet Goshtepe.
Congratulations. Well done.
Zhuoye Zhao.
Congratulations. Well done.
Mutinta Kalenga.
What a cheer. Well done. Congratulations.
Chun Hai Kwok.
Congratulations. Well done.
Ruby Lau.
Congratulations. Well done.
Huizhe Li.
Congratulations. Well done. Well done.
Jinlong Li.
Well done. Congratulations.
Siran Liang.
Well done, congratulations, well done.
Deja Luo.
Well done, congratulations.
Yan Mak.
Congratulations, well done.
Chuk Mo.
Well done, congratulations, well done.
Stefania Ntagia.
Well done, congratulations.
Darlington Ogungbeji.
Well done, congratulations.
Aisha Rani.
Congratulations, well done.
Sarah Robson.
Congratulations.
Nuria Sami.
Well done, congratulations.
Yu Xiu.
Congratulations, well done. Well done.
Chensha Sun.
Well done, congratulations.
Jingchun Zhao.
Well done, congratulations.
Yun Zhong.
Well done, well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies, Organization Studies, Yuan Cheng.
Congratulations, well done.
Christina Kiriakides.
Well done, Christina, well done.
Irfan Latken.
Congratulations, well done.
Yuan Zhen Li.
Well done, congratulations.
Sylvia Mbewe.
Congratulations, well done.
Mohammed Sakrani.
Well done, congratulations, well done.
Zhuelian Wu.
Well done, congratulations.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies with a year abroad, Nicholas Lynch.
Well done, Nicholas, congratulations.
Callum Sims.
Congratulations, well done, Nick, well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies and Economics, Haiwu Chen.
Congratulations, well done.
Zhijie Chen.
Congratulations, well done.
Ming Fang.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Chaoming Hong.
Congratulations, well done.
Oliver Jackson.
Well done, Oliver, congratulations.
Rohan Kapoor.
Congratulations, well done.
Jasnit Kaneja.
Congratulations, well done.
Xiao Kaur.
Congratulations, well done.
Kieran Ladyman.
Congratulations, well done.
Lu Lu.
Congratulations, well done.
Kalelea Mbuzule.
Congratulations, well done.
Jacob Ofosu Korea.
Congratulations, well done.
Caleb Patel.
Congratulations, well done.
Marley Ryder.
Well done.
Anton Routledge.
Congratulations, well done.
On Phi Tang.
Well done, congratulations.
Janos Toth.
Well done, congratulations.
Tu Wan.
Congratulations, well done.
Tu Yu Wu.
Congratulations, well done.
King Ye.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Pa Yu.
Congratulations, well done.
Junlu Chao.
Congratulations, well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies with Politics, Iris Hoygaard.
Well done, congratulations. Well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Security and Risk Management, John Mulcahy.
Well done, John. Congratulations.
For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Resource Management, Lindsay Gawthrop.
Well done, Lindsay. Congratulations. Well done.
Aurelio Marchena Diaz.
Congratulations. Well done.
Lachelle Marr.
Congratulations. Well done.
Annette Mulcahy.
Congratulations. Well done.
Bobette Nienye.
Congratulations. Well done.
Harriet Wellmans.
Well done. Congratulations.
For the Arts Foundation degree in Drug and Alcohol Counselling, Gail Cottam.
Well done, Gail. Congratulations. Well done.
Mindy Daliwal.
Congratulations. Well done.
Angela Fentiman.
Well done, Angela. Congratulations. Well done.
Julie Halford.
Well done, Julie. Well done.
Kirti Joshi.
Congratulations, well done.
Victoria Lee.
Well done, Victoria. Congratulations.
Antonia Marshall.
Congratulations, well done.
Rachel Monday.
Well done, congratulations.
Paul Phillips.
Well done, congratulations.
Gina Reese.
Well done, Gina. Congratulations, well done.
Daniel Reynolds.
Well done, Daniel, congratulations.
Sidel Robinson Monani.
Congratulations, well done.
Gurbinder Singh.
Congratulations, well done.
Kelly Walker.
Well done, Kelly, congratulations, well done.
Monica West.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
For the Arts Foundation degree in Security and Risk Management, Richard Asiedu.
Congratulations.
And Mia.
Congratulations, well done.
Paul Vurno.
Well done, Paul, congratulations, well done.
For the Arts Foundation degree in Managing Voluntary and Community Organisations, Joanne Miller.
Well done, Joanne, well done.
For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Management Studies, Marketing, Shinaz Stewart. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, Aurelien Melty.
Congratulations, well done, well done.
Jennifer Iwuchuku Wu.
Last but certainly not least, well done, congratulations.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're close to the conclusion of the morning's events. You've been a terrific audience. I do enjoy the whoops and cheers to liven things up. and I'm always in awe of the range of subjects that you have been studying. One that caught my eye was risk, crisis, and disaster management. I can only say to you that if you, like me, had spent the last 3 weeks in Parliament, you could have done with a course in that subject. Certainly how it felt. Never quite known what's happening from day to day. And I think we've been blessed, really, if that's the right word, with our two recipients of honorary degrees today in their different ways. Tony Allcock, given tremendous pleasure to those who've watched him, but my word, you need nerves of steel to try and get the ball near the jack when there's huge numbers of people watching you, and nerves of steel aren't a bad characteristic to carry with you in other professions, and I thoroughly enjoyed his address, as I hope you did. And Graham Beale, a proud profession to many of us who are not financiers but know the importance of and success of building societies, and again, nerves of steel to be there through that financial crisis. So I think they've both been terrific recipients of honorary degrees, and I've thoroughly enjoyed, I hope you have, listening to them, and I think we should show that appreciation now. Now, today has been a celebration, but I always think of it, as Graham said, I was a graduate here as well, a bit longer ago than he was, I have to say, met my wife here as well, so we've got quite a bit in common. But I always think when I get in front of an audience with successes to celebrate as today, it is just worth casting your mind back for a moment or two to how you felt when you started the course. I don't know about you, but I can remember it pretty vividly, even though it was a long time ago, when you arrive at a place where you don't know anyone, or very few, where you wonder if you've done the right course or come to the right university or whether you'll be able to do it, and you get moments of doubt throughout courses, usually on those grounds, and you think that everyone else looks much more confident than you do. Well, I think that, as well as the actual academic achievement that you've secured, is a very important and valuable ingredient for the rest of your careers. Because today shows that you've triumphed over any doubts and uncertainties that you felt. And the knowledge that you've been able to do this, and that you now have the security of a qualification which no one can ever take away, will, I'm sure, be of enormous value to you during the rest of your lives. And as well as your achievements, I hope you'll feel proud, I'm sure you do, of the city here and of the university where you obtained your degree. You really couldn't have been studying at a more dramatic period for the city of Leicester than the last 2 or 3 years. Last year, crowds lined the street to celebrate the finding of in the car park of a king. And this year, of course, we know what everyone was celebrating this year, the unbelievable success of Leicester City Football Club. You wonder what on earth could be done to in any way get near those two achievements in successive years. And the only link that I could think of would be if our genetics department managed to establish that Jamie Vardy was a descendant of Richard III. I think if they could do that, we'd be on the map again. Now, the Vice-Chancellor has already told you about the many achievements of our university over the last 12 months. I'd particularly like to re-emphasise what I thought was a super part that Leicester played in that thrilling mission to Jupiter. As they say, and this was an astronomer saying it, not me, the biggest, baddest planet in the solar system. And I hope that, like me, whenever in the future you hear news about the city or the university, you'll feel proud that this is the place where you obtained your degree, and maybe you'll encourage others to come and study here as well. Because a university, of course, is only as good as its students and its staff. Next year, in 2017, we'll be celebrating our 60th birthday. And during those 60 years, the university has grown spectacularly in size and reputation. When I came, there were just 2,000 students. Now there are more than 20,000 students. Indeed, there are now more staff than there were students when I arrived. And of course, it's a university which, despite its growth in size, has retained an intimacy, a friendly atmosphere for everyone. And it's no surprise to me that we always score pretty highly in records of student satisfaction at the university. And the staff, I should say to you this, on the stage with me here today, are only too aware of the debt which we all owe to you, the students, for asking questions, for the insights, for the enthusiasm and the challenges that students provide. And as a teacher, you appreciate so much the many students who you know are going on in life to do interesting and important things, and you always feel pride in their achievements. So I simply say on behalf of the staff, that as well as congratulating you all, we also say thank you for the contribution that you've made to the development and continuing success of Leicester University. And thank you as well to your family and friends who are with us today. They'll have supported you, I know, through the good times and the more difficult times, and it's only right that we're here celebrating the day together. And finally, as someone who's spent so much time in Parliament and politics, I have to wish you good luck. It's about the most important ingredient, many people say, in life. Certainly in politics, a few votes one way or the other are the difference between triumph and disaster, and nothing is predictable in politics. If you'd have said to someone 3.5 weeks ago that today there would be a new Prime Minister in Downing Street, you would have got similar odds on that to the odds that you would have got when Leicester City Football Club started last season, because these things happen with astonishing speed and with complete unpredictability. So as well as saying well done today, I do wish you and hope that in the future you get a little bit of luck as well, because I know that the degree you've been awarded today will have shifted the odds substantially in your favour for whatever lies ahead. So I do hope you'll keep in touch with us, because your success in the future, at least in part, is our success as well. Your predecessors over nearly 60 years have contributed massively to making Leicester University the fine institution that it is today, and I know that you'll be adding to that. So to all of you, I say well done, thank you, and most of all, perhaps, good luck. And now, I started the ceremony, so I'll finish in the formal way that we do. It's now my duty to formally declare this degree congregation closed.